Imagine you're working on a project, you receive a lot of emails about that project with important attachments that you need to save to a common drive. You take a week off, you go on vacation, you come back, your mailbox is flooded with email, you're digging through those emails to find those attachments. It's not a relaxing way to start off your day. Now, what if I told you that you could set it up so these email attachments are automatically saved to the drive the moment they enter your inbox, no matter where you are, so you could be sleeping and it's working for you. You don't have to hire an assistant. You just need 5 minutes to set up your flow in Power Automate. Here's how it works. You open up your browser, you go to office.com, log in with your credentials, and then you bring up Power Automate. So I'm going to go to More Apps here and select Power Automate. I want to create a new flow, so click on Create. This flow is going to be an automated cloud flow. Why? Well, because the trigger is the email. So the moment an email enters my inbox, it should be scanned. If that email has an attachment and if it belongs to a specific project or a specific person, then I want that email saved on the drive. So we're going to go with automated cloud flow. Let's give this flow a name. I'll call it save attachments. The flow's trigger is for Outlook. So let's type in Outlook to see the options that we have. We have when a new email arrives in a shared mailbox, when a new email arrives mentioning me, or when a new email arrives. This is more generic, it's for Outlook Office 365. I'm going to go with this one, select it, click on Create. First thing to decide on is the folder. So if you have a rule that moves emails to a specific folder based on the subject or the sender, then you can select that specific folder. In this case, I'm just going to go with inbox. So I'm basically going to be scanning each single email that enters the inbox. Let's go and show advanced options and adjust more settings. So one thing I want to do is make sure that it's an email that has attachments. So for only with attachments, we're going to select yes. You can adjust the importance. So if you only want important emails, so emails that are marked with high importance to have the attachments saved, then you can adjust your selection here. In this case, I don't care, so I'm going to go with any. For include attachments, I'm going to go with yes. And for subject filter, well, I want to scan for a specific subject. And that subject is Project Excel Plus, because everyone working on this project knows that whenever you send attachments regarding this project, you need to have Project Excel Plus as a subject. I can put in specific senders, but in this case, I'm just going to leave it empty because it doesn't matter who it comes from, right? So you have all these different options to adjust. Once you're done, add a new step. Now we want to make sure that every single attachment is saved. So what we're going to need is a control, and that control is an apply to each. We want this to apply to each attachment. So it says that we need to select an output from the previous step. Well, the output of the previous step is the metadata that comes from this email that's arrived. And here we need to use dynamic content. What we want to grab is the attachment. And if I go all the way to the bottom, I can see attachments here. Once we have the attachment, we need to save this on the drive. It depends where you want to save it. In this case, let's say I'm collaborating with other people and I want to save it on SharePoint. What I need to do is to create a new file on the drive. So let's just see where we have create file. That's right here. Select that. Now we need to put in the SharePoint address. Select your address. Next, you need to decide on the folder path. So if you've already created a folder that you need, you can select that. In this case, I'm going to save everything in reporting. Next, I need to give each attachment a file name. Well, that's going to be dynamic content, and it's just going to be based on the name of the attachment. So if we scroll down, we should see something like attachment name, which is right here. Then it's file content, and that's the content of the attachment. We don't have many options anyhow, so let's just select that. Okay, so far so good. Everything is set up. Let's save this. So we're saving everything to monthly reporting. Now it's not any attachment that comes in, but it's only for emails that have Project Excel Plus as the subject. So let's test it out. I'm going to click on test right here. We're going to test this out manually. Click on test. Now I'm just going to go ahead and send an email that has Project Excel Plus as the subject, and that email has attachments. And let's see if the attachments get saved properly. Okay, so I sent an email that has Project Excel Plus as the subject. We have two separate Excel files attached to this email. Now let's jump back to our flow. It says that your flow ran successfully. We can see here that it succeeded. So let's check if our files actually got saved on the drive. I'm going to bring up SharePoint, Documents. This is the monthly reporting folder. And we have the two files that were in the attachment automatically saved in here. If an email arrives that doesn't have Project Excel Plus as the title, then these attachments are not going to be saved. And notice that it's not case sensitive. I've typed everything in small letters and it still got picked up. Now you could also create subfolders depending on the sender. So let's say for this project, we want to keep the files that we receive from our boss in a separate folder to everything else. You can create subfolders here. So let's just go ahead and create a new folder. I'll call this one boss. And let's say everything else, we just want to save directly here. Boss's files will go in the boss folder. Let's go back to our flow and add a step here. Now that action is going to be a condition to check for a specific email. Now it can also be a switch. So if you have multiple different checks, you want to check if it's from the boss or from also another person, and always save these in different folders, you can use a switch. It's similar to the switch function in Excel. In case you have multiple if statements, you can always add multiple switches. The switch is going to be on the from field. So depending on who we received this email from, we are going to decide what to do. Now that from field, let's say equals info@excelplus.com. So let's assume that this is the boss. What we want to happen, let's add an action. You just have to repeat what we did before. We need an apply to each. We want to apply to each attachment. Let's scroll all the way down and select attachments. I'm just going to delete that. Then let's add an action, go with SharePoint and save the file. So basically we have to create a new file on SharePoint. Select create file and select the SharePoint drive. You can of course have different locations that you want to save everything from. So if it's from the boss and you happen to want to save it on your OneDrive, you can. Let's select the folder. So in this case, we are going to go with the subfolder that we just created called the boss folder. The file name, that should be dynamic. That's depending on the attachment name. So let's see where we can find that. It's right here, attachment name. File content is attachment content. Right, so the dynamic content makes it really easy to manage. Now, with the switch, you can have multiple cases, so we could add another one and check for another email address and decide where we want to save that file. We can add as many cases as we need. Now, in this case, just to keep it simple, I'm going to delete the other case and just go for the default condition. So if no case contains a matching value, what do we want? Well, we want to save everything to that monthly reporting folder. So I'm just going to drag and drop this inside the default. Everything is set up. I'm just going to save this. Now I'm going to go ahead and send a few emails with attachments and let's see where they get saved.
A few moments later.
Okay, so I've gone ahead and sent a few emails. There is one email with attachments but it doesn't have Excel Plus in there. So it just says not for a project. This attachment shouldn't get saved. Then I have another one. It says for Project Excel Plus. So there are two attachments here. These two PDFs, these should be saved, but they aren't from the boss. So they should be saved just directly under the monthly reporting folder. This one is from the boss. So the monthly sales reporting, this should get saved inside the boss folder. Now let's go ahead and see if this worked. I'm going to jump to SharePoint. Let's refresh this. And I can see one and two, these two PDFs got saved. The other one didn't get saved at all. And inside the boss folder, I should have one, and I do. Okay, so the flow ran successfully. Remember, you can use a condition, you can use a switch if you have multiple cases. It makes things easier to handle. This way, you don't have to dig through your emails to find attachments. You get them automatically saved wherever you want. This is how you can manage your attachments with the help of Power Automate. So I hope you found it useful. If you enjoyed this video, do give it a thumbs up and make sure you're subscribed so that I get to see you in the next video.